Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the showroom at AMS Ducati Dallas. Today we have a little bit of a celebration. We just wanted to give you a glimpse of the 916 Anniversario SP2 Panigale V4. Very long name, but very special bike. So we wanted to shoot this video because we had the privilege of our client picking this bike up. So the client took delivery Saturday of last week, and it is now mid next week. He has already completed the 600 miles for the break-in. One day he just put 400 miles on it. He rode in the rain. When this bike showed up, it was pretty filthy. So when we do a walk around, you may notice some dents and dings or some imperfections, but it's because this bike is actually getting used for what it was meant for. But we finally got it here in the flesh. It's here for the 600 mile service and a couple upgrades while it's here. So we just wanted to take a moment and bring it to you. So what are we looking at? Why the long name? So it's a Panigale V4, it's the SP2, and it's the 30th anniversary. So 30th anniversary of the 916. So as you can see, the nice big 916 on the side of the fairing there. So we've got the 30th anniversary of pretty much one of the most special bikes ever made on this planet. And you're gonna see hints in the livery of the scheme of this motorcycle to represent the Foggy's bike from 1999, the championship winning motorcycle. So a lot of Italian flag accents. And once again, we get the 916 on the side of the fairing for the model itself, coming out of 1994 in the mid 90s, and it being a very successful race bike. So this is, though, a V4, Panigale V4. And it is of the SP2 trim level. So if you guys aren't familiar, a few years back, we met our production numbers for homologation to go racing with the Panigale R model. And 2 years, we came out with an SP, and then we came out with the SP2. So I happen to have the R model and the SP2 here, so we can take a quick glance at it. So an SP2, what that means previously is an SP2 would come in the winter test livery, so the matte black brushed aluminum tank. You would get the carbon winglets. You would get the STM dry slipper clutch. And the big thing, you'd get the carbon wheels. You've got the Ergel or the billet aluminum adjustable rear sets. So you're looking at the 1100 CC Desmosedici Stradale motor that you can find in the standard or the S behind it, but special paint job, lots of carbon, a lighter weight bike, dry clutch, and then the top triple clamp was always lasered in with your production number. So very special bike, the SP, the SP2, but far removed from that flat black. We have the 30th anniversary, which is very flamboyant, loud and proud Italian. The difference with the R model, though, is the motor, and obviously a few of the ergonomics, like the swing arm pivot position adjustment, that would be for a totally different video. The R model is actually smaller displacement, but way more rowdy, way more race. The horsepower is up high. So this is as high as you get as far as performance, as far as collectability, as far as a celebration. Nothing is more special than the 916 Anniversario. So I kind of mentioned what came on an SP2 originally. So pretty much the same stuff and a little bit extra for this very, very special motorcycle. You get the carbon wheels, you get the STM dry slipper clutch, you get the carbon winglets. The Anniversario comes with the carbon air ducts for cooling the brakes down, which is a nice touch. Something I failed to mention about the SP2s, we have installed on this bike, comes with the Ducati by Rizoma gas cap. This bike also comes with the Ducati data analyzer. So if you want to nerd out on the track, break your laps into sectors, see percentage of rider aids used, traction control, wheelie control, lap times, things like that, you can use the DDA, as we call it, Ducati data analyzer. The bike also came with the billet aluminum mirror block offs. This gentleman, this client, is riding on the street, so obviously we've got the mirrors. He has a fender eliminator from New Rage Cycles, but this bike also, for, let's say, a track day, comes with the license plate delete. I won't call it a kit, but it's a plate that would totally delete the license plate back there for track use only. Once again, you've got the adjustable billet aluminum rear sets from Rizoma. This client added the carbon rear hugger to match the carbon heat shields on the exhaust, which he added, the high mount full titanium Akrapovic, and a few other small items. But very special bike. It gets its own seat that has the 30th anniversary logo on the seat with the Italian flag. You got the brushed aluminum tank. We also did the tall, dark race windscreen for this gentleman. So came out nice. And now it's already broken in. Really, really special bike. And then if you check out the dash, so not only on this motorcycle, on the top triple clamp, do you get the production number. This happens to be 111 of 500 in the world. When you turn the dash on, it gets its own dedicated animation or readout. So number 111 of 500. It has the bike sketched out. You'll notice at the top of the dash, it said Racing Pro. That's how you know that the software has been updated. We have downloaded and installed the correct mapping for this exhaust. So when you see Racing Pro on a V4 like that, you know the exhaust is there. Gorgeous bike. So that's the difference between, you know, the standard, the S, then we went to an SP, SP2. This is an SP2, but it is the 30th anniversary of the 916 with a little bit of foggy implemented in the paint scheme. Really, really special motorcycle. Yeah, one of 500, probably not gonna see another one for quite some time. But as always, if you put up with me talking, I wanna give you a little bit of a soundtrack, if you don't mind. Just in case if you haven't had enough of the high pipe Akrapovic. As I was abusing the bike, I forgot one thing. The SP2 line also comes with the MCS front brake setup with the remote adjuster for all you hardcore track guys that need to do the brake adjustment. Didn't want to forget that. So anyways, really appreciate your time. Hope you're doing well. Catch you next time.